The next topic, capital structure. After financial planning, like two types of requirements, capital requirements and revenue requirements. So capital expenditure and revenue expenditure is also there. So how the capital structure is helping in financial planning? The most important decision under financial management is related to deciding the proportion in which the required funds will be raised using different sources. The funds can be raised using owner's fund and the borrowed fund. So capital structure refers to the mix between owner's fund and borrowed funds. The owner's fund are referred to the equity and borrowed fund are referred as debt. Capital structure of a business affects both the profitability and the financial risk. Higher use of debt increases the fixed financial charges of a business, leading to higher financial risk. However, most financing decisions are taken with an aim to increase shareholders' wealth. Therefore, an optimal capital structure is the one which increases the value of equity share. Let us revise the difference between equity and debts as source of finance. Rate of return. The borrowed funds are secured against payment of interest and repayment of principal amount, so lenders may offer loan at lesser interest rate. On the other hand, the owner's funds have no assurance in terms of returns and the investment is paid back only at the time of liquidation. Therefore, owners may expect higher returns. Securities of returns. The debts receive returns to the form of interest, which is paid even if business does not earn profits, but owners' funds receive dividends only if business earns profit. Cost of capital. Cost of debt is lower as compared to the cost of equity. The interest paid on debts is treated as a business expense, so it reduces profits of the business and hence the tax liability, making debts cheaper. On the other hand, the dividends are paid out of profits after tax, thus have no effect on company's tax liability. Riskiness of the firm. The debts are more riskier because it is obligatory for business to pay interest and repay the principal amount on the predetermined time. In case of a default, company may go into liquidation due to financial crisis, whereas there is no compulsion to repay owner's fund. Financial leverages. What is meant by financial leverages? The proportion of funds raised from equity and debts can be calculated as debt-equity ratio or as proportion of debts out of total capital employed. The debt-equity ratio is also called as financial leverages or gearing. Higher the financial leverage, lower is the cost of capital, but greater is the financial risk. In order to benefit from financial leverage, it is must that the cost of debt is lesser than the return on investment. Lower the cost of debt, higher would be the earning per share. This leads to favorable financial leverages. On the other hand, if cost of debt is higher than the return on investment, the earning per share will reduce, leading to unfavorable financial leverage. The companies refer to employ cheaper debts to enhance the earning per share. This practice is called trading on equity. Trading on equity refers to the increase in profit earned by the equity shareholders due to the presence of fixed financial charges like interest. However, it is advisable that companies must opt for a risk return combination which maximizes shareholders' wealth without raising too much financial risk for the company.